Hello and welcome back to Jailbreak 2015. I'm Chris Osborne.
And I'm Sabrel Bakary. It's day two of Jailbreak and our 40 teams are well on their way. Some of our teams has got as far as France, Germany and the north coast of Scotland as well. However, four teams are already back in Lancaster with two more on their way home already. One has paid for a ferry to go home and visit home in Jersey, calling it a day. And one team is still in the race preparing for a big night out in Liverpool.
As a reminder, the ultimate goal in Jailbreak is to get as far away from Lancaster as possible. With only 11 hours left, the race is hotting up. The two leading teams are the Bloody Welsh, who are currently heading for Vienna, and Double Trouble, who are heading for Bordeaux. They're not allowed to spend any money on transport whatsoever, and they aren't allowed to do anything illegal, so no jumping on trains or sneaking onto buses. In this evening's show, we'll be looking at social media updates that have come in so far from the teams and talking to some of them to see how they're getting on. We've been receiving snapshots from the teams all day, so let's take a look at what they've been up to.
Well, it certainly does look like they're having great fun out there. Feel free to tweet us on hashtag LanxJailbreak or via Snapchat. Just find us, search LanxJailbreak.
We're now once again joined by Simon Mohammed from Anactus.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Oh, not bad. I've just woke up, so...
More awake than you were
rested,
earlier.
More rested, so yeah, all good.
Good. We've got a few of the Snapchats to have a quick look at on the screen. I think we've got a couple to look at here. The first one will be... popping up in a second. Have you seen any of the Snapchats that have come in so far?
No.
Here we go. This one, one of our production team thinks this might be somewhere like Nuremberg, which is where the Bloody Welsh have got to.
I think I've heard something about that on the exit page, so yeah, possibly.
Which is exciting to see that they've got that far. They've done really well so far.
So far, so good.
And I believe we've actually might have them on the phone now. Hello, Kate and Alex, can you hear us?
Hello.
Hi. How are you doing?
Good. We've pulled over. We've been pulled over now for about 2 hours, just trying to catch up on some of the sleep that we've missed over the last 2 days.
So where exactly are you guys now?
We're not exactly sure. It's roughly where it's plotted on the map. We stopped in, I don't know why, we stopped in some Christmas fair for about an hour.
So was the Snapchat that said stopped off for some Christmas shopping, was that you guys?
Yeah, that was us,
yeah. Yeah, we just had a look at that. It looks really good there, actually.
What are the Christmas market lights? Christmas markets but like then, down there?
Yeah. Well, it was quite... We were a bit shocked, really. We it was a bit unexpected that we stopped over. Definitely. Just to pull over to sleep, basically. So we thought that would be a good place to stop. And so we just spent the time wandering around the market. But we've moved on now to a slightly quieter lay-by. Well, it's not a lay-by, it's like a service station. It's just off the road. Trying to, as we say, catch up on some of the much-needed sleep we've missed.
So how have you guys... Can you just run us through your journey so far, then? Because you've made really good progress so far to get to Nuremberg in the time you've done. How have you actually done it?
Yeah, we've been really lucky, to be fair. We got a short little lift to the service station just outside the university, just onto the M6. Just because from there, we then got somebody, Dee, I think her name was, that was going as far as Wales. Like, the first person that took us a long way, she said, "Oh yeah, I'm going to Wales," which was weird, because that's obviously our team name. And then we stopped just as she was about to turn off. We stay on in one of the service stations. I can't remember which one it was now. And after spending about 5 minutes in hailstones and pouring rain, knocking on people's doors, we finally found a guy called, what was his name, Eddie, who was going all the way to Brighton.
Oh, nice.
And so he took us all the way down. He took us all the way down to the, I think it was the Cheam, no, what was it, the Chebham or something services, which is right down on the M25. And we got off there rather than going all the way down to Brighton, because we thought that was a bit out of the way. It was kind of there that we got informed about the issues going on in Paris. But at the time, we didn't know quite how severe they were. So when we kind of spent about half an hour, 45 minutes at those services trying to do a bit of research, trying to work out whether it would be better for us to try and go to Heathrow, which is really close to there, and spend the night there. And if we had no luck then going to Dover, or whether it would be worth just going to Dover and trying our luck, because at the time the ports were still open, but there were different sources telling us whether they were closed and whether they were open. So we called the port ourselves, didn't we, in the end, just so that we could get some sort of first-hand information. And the port just told us, basically, that as far as they're concerned, it was only Paris that was closed. And because we knew that there were no flights going in or out of Heathrow after 11:30, and it was past this point anyway, so flights don't fly out of Heathrow from 11:30 till 6:00, I think. Yeah. So we thought, well, there's no point going to there. It's just going to be quiet. There's not even going to be anybody walking around willing to sort of be Sorry, there's somebody just speaking to us. And so from there, we found there was a guy, Bert, who literally last minute we saw him as we were sort of just considering going back into the services to do a bit more research. And he was going over, he was doing a delivery, he was delivering one of the vans that he's in to Budapest in Hungary, and we've been with him all the way through.
Wow, so you've managed to go all the way from the M25 and
all the way
still...
to the M25 with the same guy, yeah.
And you're still with him?
We're still with him. So when we got to the port, it got even more kind of confusing, because on the news, the French Prime Minister had just declared a state of emergency, and he just declared that the country was in lockdown and the borders were closed.
Yeah.
And so we had a phone call from sort of the base back in Lancaster, sort of telling us that that was the situation as they knew it. But we were speaking to the border control in Dover, who was speaking directly to the French border control. And the French border control, we heard them say that it's open and that it was sort of still open, and they didn't have any plans to kind of shut it. They did say, because we were sort of having an airing as to whether or not to go at this point. So we kind of asked them whether, if the situation changed and if the border closed, as we were sort of halfway there, what would happen. And they basically said that the boat would just turn around and come back to Dover. So we thought that it was worth trying to get on the boat, because in the worst case situation, it would spin back around. It was going to Dunkirk anyway, so we were literally about 20 minutes from the Belgian border, even after we got off. And it was, there was no congestion. There was not even any sort of stopped vehicles as we were arriving in France, and there was nobody. It was just a signpost saying welcome to Belgium, the Belgian border. and this was supposedly as the country was in lockdown. It was quite surreal, really.
You guys seem to have got really lucky there. So, what's your plan? What's your plan now? Are you staying on all the way?
Well, we've undecided as to whether to kind of stop before we get to Budapest, and we've kind of decided that we may as well go all the way. We're going to try and hitchhike back, even once we're there, because we reckon that if we kind of if we find somewhere to stay in Budapest overnight, I mean, there's hundreds of thousands of hostels there, so that shouldn't be difficult. Then, I mean, if we start sort of early Sunday morning at some point, hitchhiking back, won't take as much too far into Monday, hopefully, to get back.
Well, so do you know what time you're expecting to get to Budapest then?
It depends what time we leave here. Our driver is fast asleep at the moment, which is we're quite glad of, to be fair.
Yes, yeah, I'm sure he needs the rest.
Yeah. So it's purely dependent on what time we leave here, really. He was saying that originally he wanted to be there kind of for midnight, but that's definitely not going to happen now.
Right. But easily in time for your 6 a.m. deadline?
Yes, I should definitely think so. It's about... We did look how long it was, and it's... Yeah, we should definitely be there by the 6 a.m. deadline. We took a selfie in the Christmas market, just in case that would have to be our last destination, but we should be there, hopefully.
So you basically got all the way from Lancaster to Budapest in about 5 lifts, pretty much.
That's good.
That's amazing.
Yeah. That's really good. Well,
yeah, and we met this incredible woman in just before we got a lift with Bert to here, and she was in a VW Transporter, Kate her name was. She was in a VW Transporter with one of the passengers, so she couldn't take both of us. And she was travelling an hour sort of towards Dover. And she offered to travel to drop her passenger off, come back the hour, and then take us all the way to Dover. I know. And that was at the exact same time that we'd just spoken to Bert. But she gave us her number. And she was like, when you get back into the UK, sort of give me a call. I'll take you all the way back up to Lancaster.
Wow.
So I was so impressed. I was so impressed by kind of the people that we've met on this.
Yeah, it shows you the generosity of people. It's really nice to hear that you've benefited from people like that.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for speaking to us. We'll let you guys catch up with your much needed rest. Good luck for the rest of the journey.
Hopefully we'll keep you updated
as
sort of events transpire, I suppose.
Yeah.
But
well, thank you very much, guys. We'll speak to you soon.
No worries.
Thanks.
Speak to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Cheers. Bye.
Extraordinary, hey?
That was amazing.
To see
five lifts. It's crazy.
Yeah.
All
and just
way.
How far people said
and one of
go.
Those was just to the Lancaster services.
Yep.
So then in two more lifts, they went the whole length down to the M25. So, and one
that's
more.
That's four lifts.
I think this is four lifts to get from Lancaster to Nuremberg, well, to Budapest.
Shows how easy it can be.
Amazing. Just before we spoke to those guys, we were talking about Snapchats. I think we've got one more to have a quick look at. This, I think, is Jack Hill, who we spoke to earlier when they were going to get on a Brittany Ferry. These were the ones who were given free tickets by Brittany Ferries.
Going to Cannes.
Yeah. Yes, in Brittany. So that should be exciting for them. I think they'll be... They said... I can't remember how long they said their ferry was. It was leaving at 3:15.
3:30.
No, sorry, 2:45, I think they said. So they'll be getting off the ferry...
Should be well landed now, yeah?
...sometime soon.
Yeah.
So that was really interesting to see that they're actually off to get on the ferry and they're... continue their journey. It'll be interesting to see where they end up because it's, as we said to them earlier, it's going to be an overnight job to get.
Yeah, it's like the last push now, really, isn't it? So, yeah.
I think we might be able to have a quick look at Anactus HQ, where you've been spending an awful lot of your time on the TV here. What took us through what's going on here?
Basically, well, you can't really see. There's usually 2-3 people sat at a laptop. We each have like a phone that people call up every time they change transport. If after 3 hours they've not contacted us, We have to ring them and catch up. So I was on. I was at the point where everyone was asleep, so obviously no one rang. So I was that guy that woke up every single person. I was like, "Morning, guys! It's jailbreak. Let's go." But yeah, no, it's actually it's quite a lot of fun to be honest. It's just
it's quite funny. They can see that yeah. we're watching them, and they're watching us watching them. There they are, enjoying themselves. Whatever people will do when you stick them in front of a camera. And I think we have another team on the line now. Hello, can you hear us? Hello, hello. Who, what team are you guys?
An Asian and a typical white girl.
Ah, yes, you're the ones heading to Orkney Islands?
Yep.
Yeah.
We're coming from Surrey.
Yep, how's it going?
Not quite, it's waiting quite a bit.
Okay, so where exactly are you guys now?
We're literally in the sea, on the boat, heading to the island.
Oh, that's exciting. How long ago did the boat leave?
It set off at 7.
It set off at 7, and when are you due to arrive?
It's going to take us an hour and a half to get to
all right.
the Orkney Islands, yeah.
Yeah, and then what's your plan for when you get there?
The kind stranger who bought us the ferry tickets has offered us a place to stay.
Oh, that's brilliant. Oh. So that'll be the... You've basically got a destination that you'll be at by about 9 o'clock tonight, then?
Yeah, and we could get there and try and go further, but there's not a lot here.
There's an awful lot of water between you and... between you guys and Orkney and anywhere else,
yeah,
really, isn't there?
There's not much further to go, really.
No.
Yes. Yeah, is it a particularly unpleasant boat crossing at the minute?
I'm finding it.
Not a deal.
Well, it's great.
Outside, it's making it feel worse.
Oh, nice. Nice. That sounds wonderful. It's great to see you guys. I think you must have got the hardest journey through the UK to get to Orkney. I was just going to check with Simon here. Have we had any other teams get to Orkney last year? Or have you heard of this
not
before?
That I know of, no.
So congratulations, guys. I think you are going to go the furthest north that we've had any team go.
Oh, that's good.
you know when you first initially like planned out your an actor's jailbreak?
Can't leave the UK.
I didn't quite hear that.
Sorry, my teammate hasn't got the right visa to leave the UK, so we had to make a decision.
That's why I was going to ask, why did
that's
you go north?
That's interesting to know. Yeah, because once you get to Orkney...
Either here or Gibraltar.
Yeah. It's either here or try and get a flight to Gibraltar.
To Gibraltar. Yeah, well, yeah, it's certainly an interesting option. It's really nice to see that you've managed to stay in the UK and still had a really interesting journey. What's been the highlight of it so far?
Pissing her off.
He's annoyed me a lot this trip.
Has he? Are you still going to be talking to each other by the time you get back?
I'm honestly not sure.
I don't think so.
back.
Well, hopefully you will be. I think we'll leave you guys now because I think you might just be going out of phone signal range. You're breaking up a little bit. But thank you very much for talking to us. I hope you get a nice night's sleep, courtesy of the person who's giving you a place to stay. And
can we have a name check for him?
Yeah, who's the kind stranger who's bought your tickets?
Her name's Chris.
Sorry, say that again.
Her name's Chris.
Chris. Well, thank you very much to them for helping you out. And enjoy the rest of your journey, and we'll catch up with you again soon. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
That's really interesting to see, actually. One thing you don't think of as UK students and as people who have in-date passports is that you might need visas to get out of the UK.
Yeah.
So that's why they went north.
It's not a particularly popular route for obvious reasons because it's fairly easy to get to the top of Scotland and then it gets very, very, very difficult.
Yeah.
But they're not doing badly. I think they're the third at the moment, I think.
Yeah, well, what we'll do actually, we'll have a quick look at those in the map section in a couple of minutes. But it is very interesting to see how many different directions people have gone off in. Now, we were halfway through a discussion about the Enactus HQ.
Yes.
Are you going back there tonight? Have you got another graveyard shift?
No, I'm going out tonight.
You're going out? Yeah.
No, I've got a 10 a.m. tomorrow morning, so, and then that's me done, thank God. But yeah, so it's not that bad. It's time actually flies by. It's just the time after 6 p.m. when you're tracking people back, it kind of gets harder and more confusing.
When do they have to... Is there a time limit you stop tracking them?
After the 36 hours, we track them back if they're hitchhiking, and if they've gone like, oh, we've got flights somewhere, then that's it, they're done.
Are they allowed to pay for their travel to come back?
Yeah, they're allowed to pay to travel to come back, yeah.
So that basically it ends at 6 a.m.?
6 a.m. Sunday
morning.
And
then they can do whatever they want. Either they'll hitchhike back and you guys will just keep tabs on them to make sure they missing or anything
or
happens
can
to them.
Have a few days holiday, that's what I did.
Where did you end up?
Amsterdam.
Oh, that's nice.
Stayed for a couple of nights and then paid for the ferry back to Newcastle, then hitchhiked back from there. So, yeah, it was pretty fun.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for just running us through that. I think it's now time to go to the map and have a look at how the teams are doing. So Saba is going to run us through what it looks like at the moment.
So if I refresh the map here, we can see the team we were just talking to. What were they called? Oh, of course, one Asian, one white girl. They're right the way up here. There we are. The last reported location on this map was Scrabcaster. They're just getting the ferry now. They're on their way along up to the Orkneys. The Bloody Welsh that we saw before, we were talking on the phone to them. They sent us their lovely Snapchat of them at the Christmas markets. We can see their last reported location was in Nuremberg. They're just outside now, I think they said. They're getting some well-earned rest. But as for the other teams, we've got the team that we caught up with earlier on at lunchtime. Their last reported location is Le Mans. They said that they had the Dutch man in a camper van was going to take them all the way down to Bordeaux, so it'd be very interesting to know how they're getting on with that. I think now I'll turn my attention to some of the teams that haven't quite done so well at the bottom of the list. We can see here that in 40th place, the Pussy Magnets, Emma and Ben, made it to here, which is actually in Preston. That's actually the location of a hotel, so they haven't obviously made it quite so far. We can see they've probably track their way back to Lancaster now. Other teams that haven't done well, we've got the Bruneian Wanderers, who are in Knutsford. They seem to have stuck with Knutsford. There is the team, though, that are now... they've walked from a service station in Cheshire all the way to Cheshire Oaks, apparently. They're getting ready for their night out in Liverpool. This team here walked to Wales from... the service, I can't quite remember what the service station was, but they've walked all the way to Wales from where they are. Other teams, Bath for Three Good Legs, Sam, Marta and Jacob, they're living it up in Bath. A few people decided to try the airports as well. So we've got Charity Convicts in 33rd place there at Heathrow Airport at the moment. Not quite sure how well. Well, that's quite a strange track. They've gone down to Bristol and then on to London, and Double Trouble, if I could find them on the map. Not quite sure what position they're on. They're actually on the line for us now.
They're currently in second place.
Oh, they're second place.
We believe they are about an hour from Bordeaux. Guys, can you hear us?
Yeah.
Yes, hello.
We can hear you.
Hello. Nice to catch up with you guys again. How has the journey gone?
Thank you. Not so smoothly since we last spoke.
Okay, so, run us through what's happened then.
We swapped cars about 2 hours ago, which was fine. And then about half an hour ago, our driver took us to a toll booth, and then we had to try and stop cars at the toll booth on the highway in the middle of nowhere. So we just managed to do that, and then now I think we're still on the way to Bordeaux. But we're going halfway there now, so when we get there, we still have another hour to go from there, I think.
Okay, so yeah. Is Bordeaux is going to be the destination that you're aiming for to finish?
Yeah, we're aiming for it now, but we wanted to go a bit further because we thought we'd get there earlier.
Yeah.
But we think like when we get there might be like trains and coaches and stuff. Like, because at the minute we're in quite like rural areas. There's not really much like around.
So is Toulouse still on the plan, or are we just giving up on Toulouse?
No, it is. It is potentially, like, we do have time once we get there.
One last push.
We just need to get there. Yeah, and it's and feel like one more motivated because we know the other people would fight like just a little bit. So.
Yeah.
We want to do better.
Looking at the map, you guys
Where are they?
Well, you're in second. The Bloody Welsh are winning. They are in Nuremberg, Germany. They're heading to Budapest. So I don't think you'll beat those guys because they've already gone nearly 1,100 kilometres. And you guys, your last check-in was about 700 kilometres.
Yeah.
So I think they have you beaten. You're in third place. We have the team that has headed north to Orkney. Now, they're probably going to get stuck at about 550 kilometres. So you'll probably have them, and then behind those you've got a team that are current. I think one team that's currently on a ferry, and another team that's just crossed the channel. So I think your second place is fairly safe, but I think it's a bit of an ask for you guys to try and do another 400 plus 500 maybe kilometres behind the team that's winning. But it's great to see that you guys are still going, even if it hasn't been such a smooth journey as it was earlier.
Yeah, well, we can't really stop. We're literally in the middle of nowhere. So we just sort of have to keep going.
So what's been the highlight of the journey for you guys so far?
I think today we were travelling in a camper van for most of the day, so that was quite nice. And the lady, she was like making sandwiches for us and stuff. So that was really nice.
So where did you leave the lady in the camper van? She was, I think, who you were with when we talked to you earlier.
Yeah.
She doesn't like drive in the dark. So as it started to go dark at about 4 o'clock, or like it got to about 4 o'clock, she was saying that she didn't really want to drive that much further, like as it was getting later. So we then swapped to a guy called Philip who got a speeding ticket. He got flashed by a speed camera. And then now we're in another car with a nice couple that just took from the toll booth. So yeah, but I think the highlight was definitely the camper van.
Good to see you're still enjoying it. How's the French coming along? Have you learned any more since this morning?
I mean, no, not at all. Google Translate literally like saves our lives. We can't even say like numbers.
Just say Bordeaux, it's fine.
Just say the name of your destination.
No, that doesn't even work.
And does it not?
No, I think I'm saying it wrong. I don't think about the accent right.
So were you actually stuck at a toll booth trying to find another car at the toll booth?
Yeah, and the cars were going so fast, like past us. It was like, but yeah.
That's
we were in an
aircraft.
How long did you get stuck there for?
About 20 minutes, 25 minutes.
Oh, that's not too bad.
It wasn't raining, was it?
No.
No.
No, it's not raining. Right, and it's not that cold, actually. It's
still warm. So. That's nice. It's miserable here in Lancaster, you'll be glad to hear.
Lancaster.
Well, good luck with the rest of your journey.
Thank you.
Hopefully you'll make it to Bordeaux and maybe a bit further, and we'll catch up with you guys again soon. Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
It's interesting to see that their journey hasn't been quite as smooth as... Because when we spoke to the last time, they said we're going to go straight down there all in one go.
Yeah,
they were like as solid as the guy to Budapest, really, and then stuck at a toll booth in the, I don't know, in the darkness. Doesn't sound too safe to me, but
It's lucky that they only were stuck there for 20 minutes, because quite a lot of teams get stuck for longer than that, don't they?
Yeah, I mean, you can get stuck in a city. Like, if you get dropped off in the middle of a city, it's hard to get out of. So you sometimes find that they get, like, 3-4 lifts just to get out of a city to move to another one. That's the biggest issue, in my opinion. So, yeah.
So the team that won the tickets to London, it was kind of a blessing and a kind of, it was really bad at the same time because they were being taken right the way down to Euston.
Yeah, basically.
Right.
So we've had a chat about you guys in the control room. What's been the highlight of it for you guys so far?
Well, for me, being the financial director, it's the amazing amount of money we raise, which is it's over £8,000 now.
Have you seen much change on the leaderboard today in terms of fundraising?
No change on the leaderboard.
But still V&B on £636 in the lead.
So that's huge for us. I mean, to run our four projects, we can have huge impact on a lot of beneficiaries, hopefully. So that's the main thing. That's what Jailbreak's all about, really, to fundraise to help people. So that's what it is for me, anyway. I'm really happy about it.
In the control room, everything been smooth so far? No massive disasters, no cries for help?
No fallouts on my shift.
Well, let's catch up with how it's going in there. We have the next episode of Jailbreak Diary, so let's see how it's going.
So we've got a Jailbreak update here from the team. Do you want to swivel around? Hi, guys. we are, how many hours through are we now?
We are
22.
23
hours through. We've already got 6 teams on their way back home. They've given up, which is pathetic, really. You've got to go the whole distance if you want to be part of Jailbreak. But one team are doing well. They are in Germany currently. How far are they? Nuremberg. They're on their way to Vienna. They just sent a picture of them in Christmas markets in Nuremberg, which is pretty cool. Another team are halfway through France, just going past Paris. So they're doing pretty well. But we've had some disaster moments. One being Big Z's boys, which has been an interesting episode for us here. They managed to walk 11 hours, and they made it. Where did they make it to? Cheshire Oaks. They lost one of their team members, and they're planning now to have a night out in Liverpool. But we asked them if they're still taking part, and they said, yeah, they're still doing it. So apparently Liverpool for them is far enough. But it's been great. We've been enjoying ourselves here, still getting everyone's updates. It's been great to get the pictures coming in. We've been amusing ourselves by throwing chocolate at each other, and I think we're all a bit overtired, and especially Liv. But yeah, it's been great. I'm sure we'll have another update before the end, and check in with you later.
Great to see that you guys are still just about in one piece.
Yeah.
Now, we should have another team on the phone now. Big Z Boys FC, can you guys hear us?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Hi, how's it going?
It's going really well at the moment.
Where are you guys at the moment?
We are currently sat in a house in Buckley, and my hair's been dyed pink.
Okay.
Your hair's been dyed pink, did you say?
Yeah, I lost an odds on at the start of the jailbreak, and now I'm sort of, I would say.
Fair enough.
Of all of the things I was expecting on these phone calls with teams, I don't think that was one of them. How's your guys' journey been so far, then?
Pardon?
How's your journey been so far?
Absolutely dreadful. We got to some place called Finn, and then we couldn't get a lift. So we did 6 mile walk, still. It was from 12 a.m. till 9 a.m. pretty much to get to Cheshire out. But we were absolutely down. We lost a team member along the way who passed out on the bus stop. We missed him. His mom came to pick him up.
Okay, so he didn't actually lose him. He has been taken home now.
Just a man down.
Yeah, he got in the car, I believe.
Okay.
What was your original plan? Where were you headed for originally?
My original plan was to get to Holland.
Okay.
But unfortunately, the furthest we managed to get was about 1 hour 15 minutes away.
Right.
It's not quite Holland, but I think you're planning on a night out in Liverpool, no?
We still have time. Yeah, we're deciding currently in a place called Buckley in Wales. We are either going to do like four of Wales going. Lovely place, like real place like that. Or we're going to go for a night in Liverpool.
Okay, that sounds like good fun, yeah? Yeah?
But we still have till 6 a.m, don't we? So even if we went to Liverpool, there's still a chance we could pull it back.
Yeah, I think, you've got 11 hours left. So it'll be interesting to see where you do actually finish your journey. Make sure you send us some Snapchats or some photos to see how your night progresses.
I've just had a roast dinner and my head stinks, so I don't know how I can get much better.
You just had a roast dinner?
Yeah, but one of my teammates got me a roast dinner after maths, it was lovely.
Wow,
that's nice.
Do you know whereabouts on the leaderboard you are? Have you checked?
We haven't bothered checking, but essentially we have got to a different country, so we saw moral victory. And we walk quite a lot, so I think in terms of people who walk, we win. And I think that makes it a real win.
So in terms of money raised, you're currently sitting joint with a load of teams about joint 16th.
Joint 16th, okay.
On terms of the leaderboard on £150. I don't know if you've raised more than that, but that's just what it says on our leaderboard on the website. In terms of distance travelled,
you're 38th out of 40.
With 96 kilometres at your last check-in.
Okay. Can you just tell us where the winners are at the moment, so we know?
They're in Nuremberg, Germany, heading to Budapest. They'll be there by about probably 2 a.m.
Yeah,
you know, the mileage difference.
Yes, they in Nuremberg, they're on 1,081 kilometres and you're on 96. Okay.
They're on 1,081 and we're on 96.
Yeah.
So, it's doable. What speed an hour would we have to be going?
You'd have to be going at about 100 kilometres an hour for the rest from now until 6 a.m.
yeah,
to beat them.
Yeah.
Okay, 100
kilometres
an hour.
Walking ain't
going to
do it.
Yeah, stop walking. That was a bad idea.
Yeah, I've been told we're going to have to jog.
You're going to have to jog.
Yeah, I think. A plane, I think, would be the only way you guys would stand any chance of winning it now.
Our biggest mistake was at 12 o'clock yesterday when we decided to make a 15-hour walk. Instead of making the walk south, we made the walk west in like a perfect straight line. So at no point did we actually gain any distance on the uni.
I think the actual main, like, problem was that you decided to walk and not hitchhike.
Well, honestly, there is some lovely back alleys and country roads.
Well, it's good to see that you've managed to have a nice dinner. If it makes you feel any better, the team who are in the lead at the moment are desperately trying to catch up on some sleep, and they definitely haven't had a roast dinner. So I think
they catch up on sleep. They're
trying to catch up on sleep because their driver needs it, I think, is more
important. Yeah, they need
thing. They'll have gone to Nuremberg in about 4 lifts, so their driver needs the driver they've had since London needs a bit of a rest. That's why they're having a bit of a break. But they definitely haven't had a roast dinner like you guys.
I think there should be another race to get back to us, to be honest.
Who gets back the quickest?
Well, I think, to be honest, I think even if you guys do walk all the way back, I think you would win that one over those guys.
Liam, stop down ahead. We're walking back to Lancaster.
Yeah, we definitely need to see some pictures, by the way, for tomorrow's show's Snapchats. If you can just send some in of what you guys get up to tonight, that'd be great.
Yeah, definitely.
So enjoy your night tonight, and we'll see if you actually get any further, and we'll catch up with you guys soon. Thanks for joining us.
Okay.
Cheers.
Bye. Bye.
At least they win on the food stakes. If there was a food leaderboard, I think there was
a
similar win.
Do we have a fundraising leaderboard that we could have a quick look at, I think? Yeah, here we go. We have, it shows that V and B... Oh, the wrong title's on it,
apologies
but
for that.
The team names are right and the amounts are the correct amount. V and B are still ahead on 636 with 3 good legs behind on 614 and 2 lads, 1 Baz on 503. These haven't changed much recently. Do you think there'll be much money raised by the teams out on their travels, or will they have spent any money they've raised trying to get further away?
I mean, I think it depends mostly on, like, how stuck you are, because if you're stuck in Preston, say, and you raise enough money to get a train down to Manchester, then you're probably going to buy the train ticket, aren't you, really? But otherwise, then you just put it back in the on the fundraising thing when you come back. So it's, yeah, that's it really.
As we said to those teams, we're still hoping to get loads more Snapchat and tweets in. The links aren't currently at the bottom of the screen. If you would like to sponsor any of the teams, if you go to the website, which is lanxjailbreak.com, there are loads of links all over that website to sponsor the teams. And that'll keep our financial director here very, very happy indeed.
What kind of projects are we raising money for? We were speaking about projects before.
So we run four projects. We run one in Eastern Europe at the moment, which aims to help the victims of human trafficking. We have another which helps autistic individuals in Lancaster. Another which aims to help homeless people in Lancaster, so needs and wants assessments.
Yeah.
Try and get them back into employment maybe, going to their homeless shelter once a week. And lastly, we want to help the elderly kind of integrate back into society, because in Lancaster that is actually a huge issue.
So for really good causes, then.
Really good, worthwhile causes. Yeah. It's really good.
That's good.
And how important is Jailbreak as a fundraiser for you on sort of the scale of your annual funding?
Almost 100%.
Is it?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
So it's vital that we raise as much money as possible this event. So everyone who's watching, stop watching now. Go onto the Lanx Jailbreak website and donate and sponsor
the teams.
Or just wait a couple of minutes till we end the show. And then you can be joining us tomorrow, or are you busy at 12 o'clock tomorrow? Are you on shift then?
I might be on shift then. Yeah.
You might send someone else down.
Yeah, we'll send someone else down.
Or are you still going to be hungover from...
Tonight. Who knows? Who knows if I make it? We can't be sure yet.
Well, enjoy tonight. I think, let's see if you come back with different coloured hair like our friend Dan in Liverpool. If you do, you're coming on the show, yeah?
Fair enough. That's the deal.
So, thank you very much for joining us today. We might see you again tomorrow. And we'll be back tomorrow at 12 o'clock to see who the winners are of Jailbreak and to catch up on all of the highlights from this year's competition. Thank you very much for joining us today. And as I said, we'll be back at 12 p.m. tomorrow to catch up with the final scores and hopefully interview the winners. Bye-bye.